Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're here in Sansrie's Temple, level 1, as you can see. And I think I know what to do. It was over here, I'm pretty sure, that we tried to go in here, and a wall fell down, blocking this off. Maybe one of the other switches opened this? Because this is open now. Didn't realize it. Or maybe it was caused by breaking the hourglass with the time stop hammer. Anyway, just to recap, we came in here. Had to use a serpent stone to make a teleport field appear here. We still have the serpent stone. I don't know, maybe it doesn't work anymore or something. But anyway, it brought us here. Came through here and here, fought a bunch of minotaurs in here, and then found a bunch of secret illusory walls you could walk through and get through into this area. And I believe it was here that there was a switch. Opened up this, so we can get through these illusory walls and get out, and I'm guessing also back in this way, thus not needing another stone to get through, but we still have the stone as it is. So we came through here, four minotaurs. The minotaur guard on each side, they weren't tough because we were fighting four at a time. At this point, we were only fighting one. Came through here, they were guarding this labyrinth, which we explored. There were various switches around. In here, we found a time stop hammer. And then we started flipping switches here. Which I think at that point it opened this up. And then we went through these. These are more illusory walls. In here were hourglasses. With the time stop hammer, we broke both of them. Hopefully that's a good thing. So there's a switch here we flipped. A switch here. Here. Here, here, and here. We flipped all of them. They don't flip back. This extended out this far and stopped. And I think there might be another switch or something over here that would help that extend even more. So we're gonna go check it out. We're going east. Thank you. Do we go past? No. Right around the corner here. So, could be that there's a seventh switch that needed to be flipped and had not been flipped. Aha! So this one we did not know about. Just checking all the skeletons. Alright, flipping the switch of doom. Boop. Excellent, good. Alright. That's what was blocking my progress. Now we may continue. I think it's the next one. Yeah. North. Thank you very much. Alright. So now we got to the point where we might have monsters again. So let's put up our magical barrier. Or put up our magical barrier. And put up our magical assault. And assault, and all right, we'll rest and do it again. She has rations. He has rations. Okay. Because I want to be prepared for whatever awaits us. Waiting for 8 hours so we can rest again. Okay, we're at full. Now let's try it. Barrier. Assault. And anti-magic wall. Not too bad. Now we'll save. Now I called it 136 broken is because we broke. No. we broke the hourglasses. Not that the save itself is broken. I'm just gonna call it 137. Yeah, I'll call it 137 broken in case we weren't supposed to break them. I'm still not sure. Alright, let's strafe over and surprise the enemy. Bunch more mazes. Damn it. Well, I'm not gonna strafe every time. Let's see what else we got around here. Alright, we got walls. Well, because we are right on the other side, right? So this shouldn't be that bad. It looks worse than it is. Because we're gonna have a lot of these, just dead ends or crenellations, whatever you want to call them. Just gonna make sure there's nothing, no goodies or anything interesting there. Nope, just walls. Boo! Or a boo. So there's a skeleton there. And there's a skeleton here. Okay, we continue. Oh, monster. I see you. Get over here before our anti-magic wears out. Come on, move it, buddy, move it. Faster next time. Alright, standard 4 minotaurs. We attack them with glee. We'll get our whirlwind going to attack all enemies. And do our little save in case a weapon breaks. We're using these arrows up, which is good. They weigh a lot. Of course, we have like over 600 of them. So I guess that adds up. That's how that goes. Rinse and repeat. Ah, failed. I love when their spells fail. Ah. Can't win them all though. Citrine deflected, Edgel. what's his name, our feline friend got hurt. Three of us in the front got hurt. We should start breaking out the healing. I love these dwarf axes. Freaking awesome. Alden could use healing. And Agile. Pardon me. Medium healing for Alden. And then another whirlwind for our guests. Alden is at full. Not anymore. One down. Stop throwing mountains on us. No one appreciates that. This guy's about to die. No, okay. Well, for all you know, he has one hit point left. Alright, he's close. He's kinda close. Well, our last whirlwind. And then medium healing for Citrine. These guys are all attacking the wrong thing. They're attacking the empty space where the other Minotaur died. Spell failed. Get back here! Maybe this will kill it. Yes! Love it. We want all that sweet XP. Attack that one. I think we're done. We'll save these whirlwinds for the next battle. Just have them attack range. Let Sabine just do a small healing on herself then. Full. Spell failed. Spell failed. Awesome. Free round. You notice that last hit always does the least amount of damage. I'm just gonna do a small healing on Edgel. Back in. Nice. Now we can close in on this guy and finish him off. He's gonna run before these guys can attack, but well, some of them will get attacks to Selena, Sabine, and maybe Valden. Nice. Paladin, level 25. 235 life points, 151 power points. I guess that didn't go up. 44 spell learning points, 105 training points. Rations and gold. I'm leaving these things because they're heavy. We can't really carry them. Kind of wondering. She's been using these up pretty steadily, the magical arrows. Drop the battle axe. So she still has, 73 of them. I think she had two stacks. There was one next to here. That's why there was an empty space. So she is using them up. I'm just going to save our victory. Big room. Like near the entrance. Wow. Very different from all the tunnels we've been seeing. Not sure where this goes. I'm guessing into a room that's like this. And I'm guessing there's stairs beyond it going to level 2. Getting more maze-like over here. Oops. Oh, it looked different. It looked like raised up or something. Like, do I want to step on that? But it isn't. Huh. It's like storm drains or something. Huh. Like black blood coming out of it. We want Sansrie's blood, but I guess that's not it. There's the doors we came through. Stairs here. Just a window? Yeah. Monster. Oh! Jump scare! All right. I had a feeling it would be a lot of Minotaurs. Critical hit! Wow! 127? 137 or something? That's amazing. Was that Valden who did that? If I'm not incorrect, I think Valden has a good critical hit. Alright, 2%. Yeah, it would be him. He's the only one who can make a critical hit. And it's 2%, so... figure 2 out of 100 times, he will have a critical hit, so that's pretty amazing. Let's just finish this guy off so we can advance on the others. They might do so on their own, but I'm not gonna bet on that. Alright, so I'm gonna save this. We'd just like this, like, something to break after this. Last time we had a critical hit, I restored the save, and, we lost it. Effectively wiped it from the timeline. Deflecting. Very naughty. Okay. Yeah, one of them did advance here. Two more whirlwinds. I guess a small healing on Valden. Mudsling? Eh. I want you to get left out back there. Yay. I'm gonna throw a fireball at this guy back here. He's probably gonna run up. Let me throw it there. We're probably about to kill this guy. Oh. I just wanna throw a fireball. Is there anything wrong with that? Small healing. Agile. Boom! Nice. Alright, buddy. Yeah, you can attack that. I thought it was gonna let him move up there or something. It was like messing around with it. Yeah, defend. Does he have another? Yeah. Wind Devil. No medium healing on Edgel because he's probably gonna get hit now. Nice. Small healing. Valden. Yeah, Valden. Let's just throw throw stuff at it. Paladin's healed. Ah! We're running out. I'm not throwing out the time stopper. Alright, I'm gonna have to throw out a bushel of arrows, I don't know what you'd call it. This'll drop him 10 kilos, I think. Yeah. I hate to throw it out, but we did pick it up for free, so this way we can get our gold and our rations. Now where did these... I think these came from here. I'm not sure. Let's walk around. I think we were walking through the middle. Just want to see if there was any more there to see us. Making sure I looked and poked at the skeleton there. Lost our anti-magic. Oh, Nelvin's out. No one can carry that. You're going to go and carry 19 of them. Baldwin can carry all, because he dropped those arrows. So I just need two. I mean, we're going to waste the ones he has. Nelvin. Nelvin, two. Sabine, two. Oh, look at all the gold she has. I don't suppose she can give this to one person. Is that 2987? Five? No. She's carrying an awful lot of gold. Alden will carry. So she can have two rations. Two. She doesn't need any. No. He doesn't need four of them. The ones Valden has will be wasted, but what can you do? No one else can carry that much. Unless we start moving gold all around it. I don't want to be bothered with that. don't give me that. I'm just gonna wait the 8 hours. See, this is the effect it has. All the magic coming back. She's... eh. Close enough, right? Yeah. We never use all her magic anyway. Just... I don't remember it ever happening. Oh yeah. Gotta wait. Okay. Barrier. Assault. I said assault. And anti-magic. At least we're saving. We don't have to use a light spell. Although, who knows, when we get down to the next level, we might have to do that. No! I'm glad it asks me that. Alright, finally through the door. Around the corner, boo. Alright, what's around this corner? Boo. Oh, skeleton. What's behind this corner? What's behind this corner? Ah! We got stairs up. I thought the stairs were going down into the water or something. Hmm, we've come full circle. See it drawn on a map, actually. There might be a secret. I feel like turning. Haha! Look at that. Whenever there's an empty space, yeah. Do your thing. Disarmed. Unable to pick the lock. Oh, there you go. Ooh, we got a lucky ring, a parry ring, and a target brooch. Alright, I don't know if we need any of these. Oh! And a lot of gold. Okay. For all I know, it's more cost-effective, but then again, we have trouble selling the arrows, because we have to find a slot with the vendor for each one. Oh, I can't drop from here. Hold on. We can exit and come back. Trying to make some room here. I'll drop this stack of arrows. I hate just throwing out. We're throwing out 200 arrows now between this stack and the last one. Imagine if you had to watch it all, little by little. Okay, the parry ring and the lucky ring. got slot for a ring here. There's a parry ring. Okay, so we're not currently using a lucky ring. So the parry ring gives you parry plus 25. And an armor of 2. Should I try to have him identify what the lucky ring does? The target brooch. We already have one on someone. This attack plus 25. It's pretty sweet. Anyone else need a brooch? Oh. Nelvin might be able to actually hit. Connect with his stuff. Sabine. Valden. Oh! For Valden, for sure. What's... Ugh. What's his attack at, anyway? 70. Some curiosity. 85. 100. 95. 45. 50. And 70. Yeah, and you can go above your total on this. So I would give it to Valden. Yeah, I'm gonna give it to him because half the time Nelvin, or like more like 75 or 80% of the time, Nelvin and Sabine are using spells. She's healing and he's throwing offensive spells, not attacking. Valden usually attacks, so I'm gonna give him the target brooch. But first I have to get some gold off of him because he can't carry anything. I mean, a target brooch weighs almost nothing. So now his attack is 95. He'll be doing much better. Okay, so then we've also got the parry ring and the lucky ring. See if he can identify the lucky ring. Okay, luck plus 25. I figure it was something like that. Now, I think the only thing that helps with is you not getting affected by traps. Selena's luck is horrible. But we need someone with an empty ring slot, unless we feel like we want to trade off. Eh, give it to Nelvin. His luck is only 25 and he has very low hit points. I mean, so does Selena. But she has other rings. She has a ring of strength and Sobek for swimming, which we might need soon. So yeah, give him the lucky ring. He can carry it. I hate to keep doing this. Stack of arrows here. I had a feeling that's what we'd be doing. Burning through these things. I mean, the guy can't carry a ring. Yeah. Well, actually, would it be better off to have him have the parry ring? Because that helps your AC as well. He needs all the AC he can get. So attack should be going up to 20... Well, I mean defense. Oh! Defense went up plus 6. strength. Armor, too. Oh, shield plus 5 here. Okay. It must be a combination of this and that. Alright. Awesome. Was there anything else in here? Oh, alright, there was gold. Ugh. I still can't carry it all. How many stacks of... He's got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm counting hers. 7, 8, 9, 10. We've got... Damn. We've got about 1,000 arrows, a little over 1,000 arrows, counting hers. A lot of arrows. And I think we only bought one stack of them. The rest we found. So I'm gonna drop this stack as well. Still have over 800 arrows. Look at all the crap I can carry now. So maybe now we can pick up more gold. Still can't carry it all. Alright, yeah, I gotta exit out of here. Drop these arrows. And these. So we have, what, 600 arrows left. I mean, out of all the RPGs I've played, arrows are the heaviest in this one. Now we're able to take all the gold. I mean, be honest. When are we gonna use 600 arrows? We might end up dropping more. Okay. So next episode we'll be going up, I suppose, to the next level in Sansrie's Temple. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.